Hey guys, it's Chris. From man's best friend to mummies wrapped in copper and other surprises, here are 11 amazing discoveries from Siberia. Number 11. Extinct foal. Siberia is one of the coldest places on Earth, and because of that, it's one of the few places where an extinct animal can be found trapped in ice and perfectly preserved. And that is exactly what happened in 2018, when a foal of an extinct species of horse was discovered, probably one of our first animal friends. This happened when a group of scientists were exploring the Badagaika crater, which is 328 feet deep for the record, and discovered the foal. What really made their day, though, was how intact the foal was. Though it's not clear how it died, it did so in a way that didn't leave it injured, scarred, or even bruised. So when it got trapped in permafrost, it was as if it never died in a way. At least for us. And for science. It's probably not too happy about it, though. The horse species was identified as the Lena horse, and it is indeed the best preserved ancient horse ever found. Tests in the future are going to be focusing on finding out as much as possible about the Lena horse and how it died. A new discovery was recently made that it still had blood encased inside of it. So now scientists are looking into possibly cloning this ancient horse and bringing it back. That's crazy. What do you think about that? Number 10. Woolly Rhinoceros. In the Siberian riverbank in Yakutia in 2015, a frozen river was found to be the home of a woolly rhinoceros, a creature that once existed over 10,000 years ago, and it was maybe the first real unicorn. This creature was found by a hunter named Sasha, and so the rhino was actually named after him. Research discovered that Sasha, the rhino, not the hunter, was only 3 to 4 years old when she died, and then got frozen in the river. So that makes it a baby woolly rhinoceros. And that's an incredibly rare find. That makes Sasha the only intact baby woolly rhinoceros ever recovered. They found partial remains in the past, but never a complete specimen until 2015. Sasha was later donated to the Yakutian Academy of Sciences in Russia. Since then, the rhino Sasha has been reconstructed to see what it would have looked like in full during its life had it continued on. This was done by a taxidermist who took the remains, cleaned them, and then reconstructed them into a form that fit the remains. The intent of this was to not only provide a visual for the woolly rhinoceros, but also give clues as to its biology and morphology. It should be noted that the woolly rhinoceros is not a relative of the woolly mammoth. They lived in similar areas in similar times, but they're not overtly connected. Number 9. A monster virus. Many people picture big items being found in ice as the more important discoveries of the kind, but there have been very small things found in ice that are just as important, such as many microorganisms that have been discovered in ice over the years. One of these included a 30,000-year-old virus in 2014 that wasn't just rediscovered, but revived. This particular virus was found in Siberia. But what has caught the eye of many was that this virus was still active, meaning that it could still infect people and animals if exposed to them. However, this particular virus was one that preferred to go after amoeba, so hopefully we're safe. That being said, it is a monster virus because of its size. It was measured at 1.5 micrometers long, which is one of the biggest viruses ever discovered. The species of virus is now called the Pithovirus sibiricum. And many scientists feel that this is further proof that should the ice caps and other major ice centers of the world melt, it could lead to major disasters as ancient viruses that we are not protected against could be released. And now for number 8, but first, be sure to subscribe to WorldList if you haven't already. Number 8. Tumat Dog. Two brothers named Yuri and Igor Gorokov were out by a river in Siberia on the hunt for woolly mammoth tusks. They're very valuable. And as they were doing their search, they soon came upon a dog frozen in the riverbank. While it didn't exactly look like a dog when found, that was due to it being in the ground for, oh, around 12,400 years. The scientists who are studying this canine have named it the Tumat dog, and they've been studying it for years. In 2015, a more in-depth study on the Tumat dog was allowed, and it revealed that its organs were perfectly intact, which often happens when certain creatures are frozen perfectly, not unlike cryogenics. Because of this, the Tumat dog is in fact the most preserved ancient dog to have ever been found. There's still a lot we can learn from it, including how dogs used to live 12,000 years ago, which may help paint more of a picture of the Ice Age and beyond. Number 7. Bison. In northern Siberia, a very interesting bison was found. It should be noted that this particular bison was an ancestor to the bison we see living around here today. This creature is known as a bison priscus, and it was found by a tribe of people in Siberia's Yana-Indigirka lowland. Not unlike other animals found frozen in this region, the freezing climate of the land was the reason this bison was allowed to remain in mostly one piece. And after 10,000 years of being in the ice, its brain and internal organs were all preserved, which is an incredible feat that made many very happy, as it allowed a more thorough study of the creature. One of the scientists who studied the remains of this bison noted that because of how permafrost works, bodies like this bison are usually eaten or destroyed, which makes this find, as well as the others, all the more important, as each of these animals reveal more about the times they lived in and the conditions they had to endure in order to survive. Number 6. Bone armor. Found in Russia in 2014, an armor set was revealed to have been composed completely of bone. Its age was determined to be about 4,000 years old, and it was believed to have been used by a Siberian knight. To be clear, the bones used here weren't from humans, or at least not that they could tell, but rather from animals like deer, boar, or even horse. The design of the armor itself was very custom, as it was designed and woven to apparently fit a specific person and not just made generically. This would be very impressive, as researchers believed it was made back in the Bronze Age. So would bone work as armor? Well, absolutely, if done correctly. If you think about it, human bones alone are very strong to an extent, as you pound your body weight on them at times and don't break. It does take extreme forces to cause severe damage. Certain animal bones have been documented to be even stronger than human bones, so if they got the right ones and then didn't make them too thin or fragile, it could absolutely work. As for how often armor like this was used in Siberia or other parts of the region, no one really knows. Historians stated that this kind of armor is very different from others of the area, and given the perfect condition it was found in, that would suggest it wasn't used in battle. Theories believe it might have been made as a trophy and not an actual battle instrument, but it's kind of hard to tell. Number 5. Mummies wrapped in copper. In Sulahart, Siberia, a very unusual mother and child burial site was discovered in 2017. They were discovered in a necropolis, a massive burial site known as Zeleny Yar, a place that was discovered back in 1997, and has since been a major archaeological dig site where over 100 burial areas have been found so far. What set these two bodies out in the minds of many, though, was that they were covered in copper. The adult especially was covered from head to toe in plated copper. Because of the shell that the adult mummy was found in, the team extracted the body as best they could without damaging the shell, so they could use imaging technology to look inside of it and thus preserve the fabrics and other remnants that were inside. The child that was found was believed to be no more than 6 months old. As for when the two were buried, they estimate, based on when they were found, that it was in the medieval era. Many hope that these bodies and the other 100 that have been found will shed more light on the people of the area from ancient times. At present, precious little is known about them. Number 4. The Siberian sinkholes. In Siberia, a very strange phenomenon is occurring. Mainly, sinkholes are forming at a rather alarming rate. What's more, how these holes were formed is a bit of a mystery, though some ideas are being formed as to how this is all happening, and why it's happening more frequently right now. The most popular of these holes is the one that is within Yamal. It's 260 feet wide and very deep. Even more interesting than that, though, is that there's a lake at the bottom of it. The second one is only 50 feet across, but the third one is a mere 15 feet. However, it's also cone-shaped and is said to go over 300 feet down, and more of these sinkholes are being created at random intervals. The variances with the holes aside, scientists honestly don't know exactly how these three were formed. They were recently discovered, but signs point to them being around for at least a few years before then. More so, the way they were formed seems to coincide with theoretical scientific principles, but it can't be proven because they weren't there when they were formed. At first, one of the most prevailing theories was that these sinkholes were caused by meteors that heavily impacted the Earth, and thus formed the sinkholes. But now, the leading theory is that the permafrost in the region was causing methane buildups, and when the permafrost melted, the methane exploded, and thus the sinkholes were formed. craters too, in fact. And one such crater gets bigger every year because of the release of methane. Methane is more dangerous than carbon dioxide, so these sinkholes and craters could lead to very dangerous things if left unchecked. Number 3. Permafrost explosions. In both the north and the south, there are different kinds of ice layers that people have to work around. There is standard ice that we all know, then there's a layer called permafrost. This incredibly hard layer of ice is very difficult to work around. People in the Yukon or Alaska who go gold mining, for example, know that if you hit a layer of permafrost, you're in trouble, because without special tools and time and the right temperature, you're never gonna thaw it out. To that end, you might think it's a safe thing to be around, but that's not always the case. For sometimes, permafrost can explode. In Siberia, a layer of permafrost began to heat up. While on the surface, that's not really a bad thing, this particular layer of permafrost was hiding methane sealed within it. So as the ice melted, the methane was released within, yet it couldn't escape. Its only course of action was to build up pressure. And so it did. And it did more and more and more until it exploded. This happened in 2013, and when ice starts exploding like this? That's strange, and many hope it doesn't happen in their regions where permafrost resides. Number 2. Neanderthal hybrids. In 2008, a cave within Siberia turned up the bones of a pinky that shocked scientists the world over. This was because the pinky did not belong to Neanderthals or any known type of human species at the time. Eventually, it was named the Denisovans. And after that discovery, more parts of the Denisovans were found all over Asia, helping broaden the scope of what we know about this particular species. Then another cave was found that was known to belong to the Denisovans, but this time it revealed bones that stated that the Denisovans didn't just mate with their own species, but also mated with the Neanderthals. It's an amazing lucky thing to find this individual, wow, said David Reich. Who would have imagined we could have been able to witness the hybridization of these two groups basically as it was happening? The reveal was so shocking to the scientist that the scientist who made the discovery actually checked her findings multiple times because she didn't believe the results. Then when the results were verified, it changed the way that scientists thought about both the Denisovans and the Neanderthals, because they used to think that they never met or mated, but now they wonder if they had done both all along. When you find a needle in a haystack, you have to start wondering if what you're really looking at is a needle stack. John Hawks, an anthropologist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, wrote in an email, "This genome shows that hybrids were nowhere near as rare as people have been assuming. They must have been really common." Number 1. New species of human? There are many unknown aspects of human history that are attempting to be figured out, and one of them is about where the Native Americans came from once upon a time. And one of the biggest theories is that they came from Eurasia, possibly even Siberia, when the lands were held together by a land bridge. As such, many scientists have gone to Siberia and other places to find remnants of the early versions of the Native Americans to tie them together. However, a recent discovery suggests that there might have been another group of people living there that we didn't even know about before. Bones and remains from 34 different individuals were found in north and eastern Siberia. Two remains from a place called the Yana Rhinoceros Horn Site revealed DNA that didn't match anything known from the Native Americans or any other human groups. What we see here is a much more complex story than what we believed was the case, said the director of the Lundbeck Foundation Center for Geogenetics at the University of Copenhagen. This group of humans, dubbed the Ancient North Siberians, were not known about overall, and yet their remains prove that they were a rather widespread group. What's more, they were definitely ruled out as ancestors to the Native Americans, which means there were even more people living in ancient Siberia than previously expected. Thanks for watching. What did you think of these amazing discoveries from the land known as Siberia? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to Worldless before you leave, and I'll see you next time.